Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. For many decades, consensus scientific theory has held that the universe began many billions of years ago in a primordial creation event that defies all the laws and principles of physics. On this series, we have reported on many increasingly fatal discoveries for the Big Bang theory. From impossibly huge objects that exceed the theoretical size limit of any object at this time in the Big Bang universe, to so-called impossible stars, whose chemical composition is completely wrong if they formed from material in the early universe, to grand design galaxies that display a complexity of form that defies their theoretical age. Today, astrophysicists are again resorting to new conjectures to try to preserve the Big Bang story. The latest irreconcilable data comes from scientists' attempt to analyze the so-called cosmic dawn, a period about 200 million years after the hypothetical Big Bang, when the earliest stars are thought to have started to shine. The scientists have used a radio antenna called the experiment to detect the global epoch of reionization signature, or edges. Their goal was to study the absorption of radiation by hydrogen flowing between the so-called earliest generation of stars. What they report to have found is that the hydrogen gas appears to be much cooler than expected, too cold in fact for the Big Bang theory to possibly explain. Today, science headlines are reporting an ad hoc theory invented by two astrophysicists, which is intended to save both the Big Bang theory and the hypothetical existence of dark matter. In a new paper in the journal Nature, the astrophysicists propose that a tiny fraction of dark matter has an electric charge, which they suggest could be responsible for the hydrogen's anomalously cold temperature. Astrophysicist Stephen Furlanetto told the website livescience.com, "If Edges is correct, I don't think there's any conventional explanation that's compelling. You really need to go to one of these non-standard physics scenarios. In that case, I think it's wide open." But this latest attempt to redeem both the discredited Big Bang theory and the futile search for dark matter cannot be described as a, quote, wide open effort to explore new possibilities. The Edges endeavor is based on the premise that the Big Bang actually happened. This latest finding of anomalously cool hydrogen is only the latest in an endless string of fatal discoveries for the Big Bang hypothesis. If astrophysicists are actually interested in, quote, non-standard physics scenarios, the most promising foundations were laid decades ago by the late astronomer Halton Arp. Arp's exhaustive research into the anomalous redshifts of quasars revealed that the universe is currently of unknown age and extent. Arp's thesis was supported by noted astronomers such as Fred Hoyle and Jeffrey and Margaret Burbidge, among several others. The only attempt to discredit Arp's discoveries was based on statistics and did not use his highly specific and successful predictive methodology. The abstract in the Nature paper states, "The dynamics of our universe is strongly influenced by pervasive, albeit elusive, dark matter, with a total mass about five times the mass of all the baryons." But this statement is purely speculative and has no factual basis at all. No experiment has ever detected dark matter, and as we have documented for over 6 years on this series, the quest to prove the existence of various types of dark matter has only proved futile. Of course, it's deeply ironic that scientists are now invoking electrically charged dark matter to try to save the Big Bang story. The fact is that earthly gravitational theory does not work on the galactic scale. In the early 20th century, some astronomers proposed dark matter as a possible solution to the anomalous stellar rotation profiles in galaxies. The mystery was, why do Newtonian dynamics fail to explain the impossibly high velocities of rotation of the outer stars in galaxies? Later scientists using galaxy rotation curves also proposed the need for many times more dark matter than visible mass. But scientists today increasingly acknowledge that the many different types of hypothesized dark matter, even including electrically charged dark matter, have run out of places to hide. However, for decades, plasma cosmologists have explained galactic rotation and detailed features of spiral galaxies in electromagnetic terms, a breakthrough that astrophysicists continue to ignore. In fact, as we reported in recent months, retired professor of electrical engineering Dr. Donald Scott has published a paper in which he compares the predicted stellar velocities based on his model that the galaxies are fed by electrical Birkeland currents, and the actual stellar velocity profiles measured over many decades. As seen in this graph, the two compare remarkably well.
The velocity in these stars, really, in the real world, and they've been measured like this for 85 years now, they vary as the square root of r. The last picture is a comparison of the predicted and actual stellar velocity. So if you take my model of the Birkeland current and assume that it's feeding the rotation in the Birkeland current is responsible for the rotation of the galaxy, that is the comparison between the actual velocity, which is that sort of wiggly, sort of a very lazy S curve, and the square root of R is the smoother curve there. And that's exactly what my Birkeland current model predicts should happen. So there's no surprises. And these guys have been chasing their tails down a box canyon for 85 years now, looking and crying out that they know that dark matter exists, but they can't find it. That's because there's no reason for it.